Hi, I'm Dr. Joel Hunter, and today we're going to talk about the sniffles. Why do we cry and then get the sniffles? This is Lit Explanations. So when it comes to the sniffles, it's so common that we don't think about that it's kind of a weird thing. You know, if you are cutting onions and then your nose starts to run, if you see something sad in a movie and you cry, I've never seen The Notebook, but I've heard it's really sad and people cry. And when they do, they get the sniffles. Well, there is a good medical name for it, but since sniffles is probably more famous, that's what we're gonna call it today. The sniffles, it brings together two seemingly unrelated things. The water that we're making with our eyes, and then we get a bunch of snot. And those two, your eyes and nose, they're different from each other. So why would that happen? Well, it comes down to tearing. It comes down to the type of tears that we have. So when we talk about tears, there are two types. There are your baseline tears, and then there are reflex tears. Now, reflex tearing is considered to be the same as if you said, like, hey, that guy is really crying over there. You wouldn't be talking about his baseline tears. You'd be talking about reflex tearing. Baseline tears are different. They are what keep the surface of your eye nice and smooth and polished all the time. And to explain this a little bit better, I'm going to be drawing out a little bit of the anatomy of why you have two different types of tears and where they come from. Clean this up a little bit here, and we're good. So, tears, they come from glands around your eyes. So if I was going to draw a human eye, I would kind of do this over here, a little thing there, and then like this. And then this is an upper lid eyebrow. Well, it'll be right here. It's a very manicured eyebrow. Manicured. And then this would be where your actual eye would be. Here, this is, I'll do that, and then here's your pupil. All right, so that's an eye. The tears that we have, so we were talking about there's baseline tears. Baseline tears are what just keep the front of your eye polished all the time. There's just enough there that the front of your eye is wet, but not overflowing. And where it comes from is actually along all these little, there's these little tiny, bajillions of them, these little glands that line the inside of your eyelid. If you were the weird kid in class or knew the weird kid in class that would flip his eyelid inside out and you'd show you the pink part of his eye, it's there. It's palpebral conjunctiva, if you flip that over. This area, so these little glands, they've got names. They are the glands of Krauss. That's an S. And also the glands of Wolfram. So Krauss, that's gonna drive me nuts. Hold on, I'm gonna erase this one S for a rare mid-video edit here, so that we don't have to look at that. Glands of Krauss and Wolfram. So these just constantly are producing just a little bit of tears, aqueous tears all the time, so that you just have enough on the front of your eye. But what happens if you don't have enough baseline tearing? That's when reflex tearing comes in. And that comes from this big old giant gland over here. It's this big thing like this. This is called your lacrimal gland. Now your lacrimal gland is able to produce huge amounts of tears. Now not like big enough that you could fill up a gallon of jug of milk or something like that, but big enough that your eye can't possibly hold all of those tears. Your eye can only hold about 10 microliters of fluid on it at any given time. So lacrimal gland, it comes along and it just pours out from your upper lid and then it washes across the front and then pours down your face. If you've ever purposefully stared into a car air vent, you know, for long enough and let that wind just blow by your eye enough to dry off the baseline tearing, your eye senses that. It senses it's too dry here, we have dry spots, and then in comes their lacrimal gland for reflex tearing, which is why shortly after you notice that feeling, you'll start pouring tears down the side of your face because your lacrimal gland's sending all that down. Now, what does this have to do with sniffles? Well, I'm glad you asked. We're gonna get to that. All right, so back to our lacrimal gland. So I'm gonna, well, here it is up here, this big guy. That's not an exact rendering of it, but that's the idea. That's the, what the gland looks like. And so you've got this thing, it's attached to your eye on the inside. So it's gonna make these little tears. And what happens is these tears pour out and over the surface of your eye. And your eye can only hold, that's that number that we were saying, it can only hold about 10 microliters of fluid, but like that's not much. In one drop of liquid, there's about 50 microliters of fluid. So one drop of tears is already 5 times more than your eye can hold. So it can pour down your face, and that's what crying is. That's this. Which actually has a medical, that's not a very good teardrop, is it? There we go, there it is. This actually has a medical name called epiphora, but most people just say crying. And so that's when you cry, but that's not how it's built. Like it's not actually how your eyes aren't built to just lose the tears off the surface by just having them overflow onto your face. There's actually in your lower lid here. So this is the margin of your lid. There's a little hole, and in your upper lid up here, there's an even littler hole. And each one of these is called a punctum. Now the punctum is an opening. This is a lacrimal punctum because it's an opening that's designed to collect your tears. It's like you got your own little drainage system, it's like your own sewer pipes in your eyes, only with clean tears in them though. And so what happens is this punctum is an opening and it actually connects to this thing. There's stenosis there, but this thing is called, I'm gonna come over here for this. This thing's called a nasolacrimal duct. Lacrimal has to do with crying and tears. Lacrimosa, the Mozart thing, is crying. Naso, nose. And so you can guess where this duct connects to. You're crying and crying, your tears are flowing out into, at the nose, into your nose. And that's where they, on both sides, you have this nasolacrimal duct and it opens up in here. And so when you are crying and when you start to get the sniffles, what you're actually sniffling are your own tears. And that gets mixed in with, nose juice that's in there. But when you are crying a lot and your nose gets stuffed, it's because you've poured tons of your own tears down your nasolacrimal duct into your nose. When you blow your nose and you've been crying, you're blowing tears out of your nose into that Kleenex. So that's why we get the sniffles when we cry. Hope that helps. Oh man, bonus footage. Babies. When they're born, that little punctum and the nasolacrimal duct, a lot of times it's not all the way open yet. And so sometimes when you see babies and they've got really like goopy eyes, crusty eyes, that's why. And then it has to, you do this little eyelid massage to open it up so that when they cry, they'll start to get the sniffles when they're a little bit older. Thank you. That's all of today's video. Have a wonderful day.